sahanavavatu sahanau bhunaktu sahaviryam karavavahai tejasvinavadhitamastu ma vidvishavahai. Om shanti shanti shantihi. Samasta jana kalyane niratam karunamayam namami chinmayam devam sadgurum brahma vidvaram. Om purnamada purnamidam purnat purnamudachyate purnasya purnamadaya purnameva vashishyate. Om shanti shanti shantihi. Om Ishavasya Midagam Sarvam Yatkinja Jagatyam Jagat Tenatyaktena Bunjitaha Magradakasya Svidhanam Kurvanneveha Karmani Jiji Vishechatagam Samaha Evam Tvayinanyate Tosti Nakarma Lipyate Nare. Asuryanamate lokaha andena tamasavrataha prithagumse prithya vigacchanti eke chatmahano janaha anejate gam manaso javiyah naina deva apnuvan purvamarshat taddavadonyanatyeti tishtat tasminnapo matarishvadadadi tadejati tannejati taddure tadvantike tadantarasya sarvasya tadu sarvasyasya bahyatah yasmin sarvani bhutani atmanyevanupashyati yas Udayeshu chatmanam tato na vijukupsate yasmin sarvani bhutani atmaiva bodh vijanatah tatra ko moha kashokah ekatvam anupashyatah sabaryaka chukramaka yamavranam asna viragam shuddhamapapa viddam Kavirmanishi paribhu swayambhu yata tatyatorthan vyatada shashvati bhyasamabhyah. In this Upanishad, we have seen so far the absolute knowledge which leads one to realization of the oneness, which is Ishavasya Midagam Sarvam. From there onwards, here, the vision of a jnani was given in the previous two verses, 7, 6 and 7. Yasmin sarvani bhutani atmanyeva anupashyati. Then, and also, sarveshu bhudeshu cha atmanam pashyati yaha tatra kaha. So, tataha na vijukupsate. Yasmin sarvani bhutani atmaiva bodh vijanatah tatra ko mohah kashokah ekatvam anupashyatah. Where is delusion, where is sorrow to a person who has seen this oneness? Now, here in this verse number 8, to conclude this portion of atmajnanam, final thing is about the indicators, lakshanani, of Atman is given. Saha Atma Paryagat. We saw that yesterday, few of them. Paryagat means Paryagat, agat means that which is moving or everywhere, all pervading. Shukram. Shukram is here, we have seen the Paryagat word that comes from the root word Gam Gachati. But that gam word not only means about gamanam, but also avagamanam, to know. So that which is all-pervading, at the same time, because of the fact that it is all-pervading, it is all-knowing as well. That which is everywhere obviously has an awareness of everything around at the same time. So here, Atmanaha Lakshanani Chaturvidani, four of them are there. That is, one is Prapti. I have explained to you that also there yesterday. That is Vyapti, Jnapti, Prapti and Mukti. Vyapti means Vyapakam, pervasiveness. Then Jnapti is Jnanam, to know. And then Prapti means it is capable of obtaining everything. Then finally Mukti, that is of the nature of freedom. So here it is given as in the meaning of Paryagat. Paryagat means that which is of all-pervading nature. And it is Shukram. Shukram means Jyotisham Abhitat Jyotihi, that which is of the nature of brilliance. Shukra is of bright, that which is of the nature of brilliance, Swayam Jyoti Swarupaha. It is of the nature of self-brilliance. That's why Bhagavan Krishna says in Gita, Jyotisham Abhitat Jyotihi Tamasaparamuchate. It is that light with which you can see even the darkness. Very interesting, right? With light can you see darkness? But this is such a light, we can see darkness also. What does it mean? See, with our eyes we can see light, correct? Can you not see with the eyes darkness also? So the eyes are of that nature of brilliance, ability. You can see what is light as well as what is darkness. In the Vedantic context, what does it mean? Jnanam, Atmajnanam is that which is aware of both Vidya and Avidya. My awareness is capable of knowing what I know. Also, it is aware of what I don't know. Avidya also. So, it is awareness which is neither Jnanam nor Ajnanam. It is Jnapti. It is of the nature of knowing, capital K, knowledge, not Buddhi Jnanam. It is not a knowledge gained out of Buddhi, but it is awareness which is capable of knowing both knowledge as well as ignorance. Just like eyes are capable of seeing both light and darkness. That's why it's called Jnapti, Shukram. And next word that is given here is Akayam. Kaya means body, basically means Kaya. But here Akayam, when it is said, it is not about physical body, because that will come later. Akaya means that is not Sukshma Shariram. It is not Antakkaranani. It is not Mana Buddhya Hankara Chitta. So in this, it is not the mind. It is not the intellect, meaning this is called as Sukshma Sharira. This is a subtle body. It is not subtle body. Why it is so? Because later on it will be given Avranam and Asnaviragam. Avranam means that which does not have Vrana, means destruction, Akshatam Ityartha. It is not subject to destruction, because when the death takes place, what gets destroyed is this. Right? Body. And according to Vedanta, the subtle body is the one which is called shuttle body. Along with the samskaras or vasanas, it is moving to the next body. Therefore, akayam is referring to this sutula sharira, which is not subject to death at the time of death. But Atman is not this. Secondly, this is what is called avranam. It is not the gross body also, which is subject to death during the time of physical death. And it's an asnaviragam, which is that no muscles. Snava means muscle. Asnaviragam. It is not subject to departure or division, dissolution, asnaviragam. Therefore, nasthula shariram together. So, these are all indicators. As we see, chant this, what do you call that? Nirvana shatakam. Mano buddhyahankara chittani naham. That means what means na stula shariram, na sukshma shariram. I'm not gross and subtle bodies. Then shuddham, pure, which means what? Na karana shariram. It is not also the impurities that are there in the form of our past impressions, which makes our karana sharira. Therefore, it is referred here as shuddham. It is not karana sharira. With the karana sharira or the subtle causal body is that which has the sins also. Therefore, it is an apapa viddham. Pap se na vidda. So, it is not, vidda means to pierce, to injure. It is not that which has the sins of the past which is constantly hurting. Apapa viddham. So, these are all said in neutral gender, yes, you see it. Paryaga chukram akayam avranam asna viragam shuddham apapa viddham. Now comes in the masculine form, kavihi. See, when we thus recognize that we are none of this body, not this body, shutula, not the mind in it like stukshma, not the vasanas, karana sharira. If you leave this, this won't exist. Objects, emotion, thoughts are come to be comprehended only from the standpoint of body, mind and intellect. So, when that is not there, what is your vision? What is that you see? Kavihi, krantadarshi, not conditioned by time. The vision will become unconditioned by time. Therefore, kavihi, krantadarshi, sarvadruk, sarvam, darvam, bhashyadi, idi sarvadruk. One who is the vision of everything. And also manishi, manasaha neta, becomes a director of the mind. Manishi, not one who has very ishitvam of money. Only manishi does not mean not ishwara of the money, but it is manasaha ishwaraha, not manis ishwaraha. So manishi, sakshi, prabhu, shasta, neta, manaha, the one who is the director of the mind. That's what the Kayana Upanishad asked that question. The first question is what he asked. Keneshitam patati preshitam manaha. Kena prana pratama praidiyuktaha. Keneshitam vachamimam vadanti chakshusrotram kaudevo. First question he asked is, how is the mind false on the object? By whom? Manishi, the one who is behind manasaho. That says, yen manasa namanuti, enahur manomatam, that which is the very impeller of the mind. Paribhuhu sarvasya upari bhavati. Paribhuhu bhavati is above all of them. These are all indicators, as I said, lakshana of the Brahman. And then swayambhuhu. Swayambhuhu means self-born. Akaranaha and sarvakaranaha. It itself does not have any karana, it is, does not have its own reason to be there, but it is not having its own cause, but it is sarva karana. At the same time, it is the cause of everything. Swayam prakashaha sarva prakashakaha. It is of the nature of self-illumination and illuminates everything also. Tameva bhanta manabhadi sarvam. That is called swayambhuhu. So, and what is that function of that or presence of Brahman is for what here? Yatha tatyato arthan vyatatati, vyatatat. So, yatha tat means as it is required. Yatha yogya vyatatat, vyatatat means arthan, arthan, vishayan. So, for the Brahmas or the Prajapadis, Prajapati is also subject to certain tenure only. He is also an appointed position. Brahma is not an absolute, it is an appointed position. That appointed position, when it is over, then he also has to withdraw from himself, then another Brahma would come there. So, who allots the function, what the Prajapati has to do? This Brahman, which is taken to the form of Ishvara. See, when it is saguna, it is Ishvaraha, nirguna is Brahman. If I ask you, are you a husband? Yes, that is saguna swabhava. And I am a human, when you say nirguna swabhava, in this context. Who are you, a man or a husband? Both, isn't it? But before you married, you were what? Nirguna Brahman. And this I am only a man. Or you can say, I am. Then if a man or a manushya, man or a manushya, then what will you say? Manushya is nirguna, man again becomes saguna. Man is nirguna, husband becomes saguna. The husband is nirguna, parent becomes saguna. Further added qualification, goes on adding qualification. So, from parent to husband to human to, I mean, man to human, then life. As a life form, what are you? Nirguna. As a human becomes saguna. Again. From there, it is nirguna. When the husband becomes, it goes on like added qualities. So, life. So, are you life or being? Life means again expressed form with some equipment. I am. Who nirguna hai? Nirguna Brahma is a Paramatma Sarvayambhu Paribhu. But when it takes to a position or a form, then become saguna. So, Ishvara has saguna, Brahman is nirguna. But as a saguna swavavena, by as a Ishvaraha, he is responsible to allot the functions to the Brahma. So therefore, he gives according to the Prajapati's need, requirement, he impels the Brahma or Sutratma or Hiranyagarbha to engage in creation according to the samskaras of each jivas. We saw that earlier also. That's why Bhagavan Krishna says, Sutre Manikanaiva. That word is very important there. All living beings, their antakaranas are connected. Vasana, vasana, the antakaranani, all are connected to one single string. That string is Sutratma. And Krishna, identifying with that, he says, Aham Sutre, Sutre Manikanaiva. In that sutra, which is a string of all the antakaranas as well as the vasanas, all the living beings are embedded there and function. Therefore, he said, Ishvara sarvabhutanam hriddeshe arjuna tishtati brahmayan sarvabhutani yendra arudhani mayaya. Living in the heart of everyone as sutratma, he impels individuals to act according to their vasanas. So here, he is the one who is making the Sutratma Hiranyagarbha engage in the act of creation, which is nothing but manifestation of the jivas which were in the Ralayasthiti before, to express themselves according to their samskaras into the world as jivas. But when he is a Nirguna Brahma, obviously, there is absolutely no role to play for himself. Yatha tat. As it is required, yata yogyaha vidadat, he appoints and allots. What? Vishayan, artan, the various individual engagements or the, according to the vasanas, what is that they need to do. This is according to Vedanta. Now it's the Vaishnava tradition. Now, Vaishnava tradition says, whatever is given in the neuter form is nirguna, whatever is given in the saguna, in masculine, it's all saguna. Masculine is saguna because Brahman is nirguna swarup. So, whatever is given in neuter form is belonging to nirguna lakshanani, and whatever is, that is Brahman, Brahmanaha lakshanani, and whatever is given in masculine is Ishwarasya lakshanani. Now, you look at the verse again. Now, if you look at it carefully, saha, saha is masculine, so leave that again. Paryagat shukram akayam avranam asnaviragam shuddham apabhaviddham. These are all nirguna atmanah lakshanani. That is, he the one who is all pervading. Brahman all pervading, pure, bodiless, I mean sukshma sharira rahitaha, sthula sharira rahitaha, Karana Sharira Hidaha, these are all the Nirguna Brahma Swarupa. Saguna Brahma Swarupa is Kavihi, Krantadarshi, Manishi. He is the one who impels the mind, Paribuhu, above all of them, Swayambuhu, self-manifesting, then allotting all the various functions for the Brahma. So that is, all this are in masculine. That is Saguna Brahma. Saguna Brahma Ishvara. Right? Now let us look at another standpoint. Another standpoint is, what is said before was the two verses before. What was this? Yasmin sarvani bhutani atmaneva anupashyati. Sarva bhutesh atmanam tato na vijugupsade. This is about what? About a jnani, right? Jnani purushasya vision, the drishti of the jnani. Also it is said, sarvani bhutani atma eva abhut vijanatah ekatvam ekatvam pashyatah kaha mohah kashyoga. Jnani who has seen that the Atman itself is manifesting as the universe. About the Jnani, it is Saha. That Jnani is, one who has reached that point of realization, he is Anupashyatah Vijanatah. For him, all these qualifications. Saparyagat Shukram Akayam Avranam Asnaviragam Shuddham Apabhaviddham Kavihi Manishi Paribuhu Swayambuhu. And such jnanis who have reached the state of total realization with the oneness with the self, they are the people, please note, Ishwara appoints them as the one who decides what others should do. They become rishis. And those rishis are those who are giving this instruction to Prajapati. E aap e karo. These masters become eternal masters. So they are the Vedadat Tashvadibya Samabhya. They become the giver of this, allotting these, the functionalities of the Brahma, who will in turn will be able to make the jivas function accordingly. So they are the exalted souls. Like we have the Sanat, Sanaka, Sanadana, Sanandana, Sanat Kumaras. There is a story I read somewhere very beautifully. Once Bhagavan Shiva was going on his bull along with Parvati as they were going. These Sanaka, Sanadana, Sanandana, those were there, the four of them below the Dakshinamurti. They were exalted souls and they were living in their own, you know, gay abandon. You know, they are in their joyful abode. They were not worried about anything else because they were filled with bliss. So when Bhagavan Shiva was going and they were not even bothered to even get up. Because they were not even aware of what is going on. They were in bliss. Parvati got very upset. You people standing there or sitting there without even recognizing that Maheshwara is passing by. She cursed, become camels. Wound mana, wound ho jao. They are not wounded, but anyway. So, they become camels. And Bhagavan Shiva did not notice, he proceeded on. After some time, he was wondering, hey, this Sanat Sanatana Kumar, they are not coming down nowadays to see me. What happened to them? So, he asked Parvati, you know, you have seen them? She couldn't say anything. Yeah, I've seen them. Why they are not appearing nowadays? What happened to them? We'll go and see what is happening. I'm not coming. She said, I'm not coming. Why? No, I have something else to do. So he went looking for them. They were all, four of them were sitting like, they were sitting and they were there, Aram say, in the hot sun, they were sitting there in Arabian forest, Arabian, what you call, desert. Jolly was sitting and then the grass and all they were eating. He recognized them. Kya hua? What happened to you guys? He says, when you were passing by, we didn't get up. So Parvati ji, Mataji has cursed us to become like this. So are you not feeling bad? Nothing. Aram se ho. Abhi to kahi jaane ka bhi nahi hai. Somebody is bringing our food, then we are just eating and enjoying it. Blissfully we are there. They are there in any form, any every form, they enjoy it. So that's the nature of this Mahatmas. They are not worried about which form they are taking. It doesn't matter. Physical form, how does it matter? Now, this section is over about the nature of and Lakshmanani of this Brahman. Now, they are getting the food ready, so I'm going to make it up to 8:15, okay? So, don't worry. Andam tama pravishanti e vidyam upasate tato bhuya ivate tamaha yau vidyagam rataha andam tama pravishanti e vidyam upasate tato bhuya ivate tamaha yau vidyayagam rataha. The word avidya and vidya, we need to understand this is referring to para, not para, apara vidya. So you see, usually when we translate literally means vidya means knowledge and avidya means ignorance. But here we should understand in this context, because the discussion about the Paramatma Vidya, Brahma Vidya is already completed in the previous verse itself. Now, Kuruvanneveha Karmani Jijivishe Chatagam Samaha, what is spoken in the second verse, that what is that Karma Kuruvan Jijivishe? What karma one should do, that is now taken up here. Action is born out of avidya, as you all know. Ignorance of the self alone makes an individual desire for the objects of the world. And therefore, karma is referred here as avidya. And vidya is devata upasana. Upasana or contemplation upon given deities from the higher standpoint, or upasana also means TV upasana, internet upasana, mobile upasana, Facebook upasana. Upasana means being close. Facebook, you have to face the book and only they become Facebook. Any kind of indulgence and engaging in the indriya pravritti, that is called here as at the lower level, upasana. Though in commentary of Gurudev, you will find that this is, according to him, that is not acceptable, because it says that is too traditional. And you see the commentary of Gurudev, but let us see what Shankaracharya brings it here as, ye manushyaha avidyam karma upasate, upasanam karoti, andam ajnana atmakam, tamaha darkness pravishanti, they enter. Ye manushyaha vidyayam devata jnana rupam rataha ramante, te, those people, tataha u, than that bhuya iva adhikatama adhikatara tamam andam tamam pravishanti. That is understood. Meaning, those who are engaged in karma alone, prescribed by the Vedas or whatever it is, thinking that they will be able to gain higher logas to experience, or here itself, Esha Prapti, Putra Prapti, and all those things, and about the wealth and name and fame and other things, they enter into intense darkness. Those who are worshipping or engaging in the Indriya Janita Jnanam, Indriya Arteshu Rataha, here they are referred as Vidyahum Rataha. Vidya, where is the knowledge coming from? Through Indriyas only. right? Sensa are jnanendriyani. They are the ones which are giving. In those which are reveling in only those, these people, tato bhuya eva tamaha pravishanti. They enter into greater darkness. So, what is spoken was Brahma Jnanam, but here it is about karma, which is avidya, and vidya here referred to upasana. Upasana means, like as I said, it is not, devata upasana does not mean worshipping a personal god, but here that will be taken later, but it is referring to upasana of indriya vishayas. So, we have to understand that the karma and jnanam samuchay is not going to be possible. Knowledge being the one which is a destroyer of avidya, karma being the caused by avidya, cannot go together. Karma is an effect of avidya, whereas knowledge is a destroyer of avidya. They cannot go together. They call samuchaya is not possible. What is possible is samanvaya. The word samachaya and samanaya means where the karma ends, jnanam will start expressing itself. Where karma has brought an effect of purity of mind, then only jnanam will start giving its effect. Therefore, as the darkness ends, the light will be shining. Or when the light starts shining, dark would have ended already. Therefore, karma, jnana, samanvaya is possible. Consequence, succeeding one. Therefore, karma and jnana, samuchya, yugapat, together abhyasa is not possible. So, if at all yugapat, abhyasa is mentioned anywhere, it is only karma and upasana. That's why when we go to a temple, the priest is doing many different karmas there, rituals there. And you can also think and contemplate upon the given particular deity. This contemplation upon a deity is also called upasana. That is possible. While you are doing a karma for a particular deity, you can do the upasana also. That is possible. But jnanam destroys both. Because devata jnana, any upasana is betatmakam. You cannot do any upasana keeping that deity as yourself. It cannot be possible. That is why when you are doing a puja also, you invoke the deity onto the form, right? Yehe hi gaurisha pinakapane shashankamole vishabadiruda devadi devesha mahesha nityam grihana pujan bhagavan namaste avahyami devesham madhimadhyanta varjadam adharam sarvalokam ashridatta pradayinam. You are invoking him there. Into that form, then only you are actually doing upasana. So, bedatmakam upasana. It has to be a difference. If it is you yourself, then upasana is not possible. Asana is possible, not upasana. Abidance is possible, not worship. Therefore, here, the very nature of upasana is duality. When duality is there, obviously there is either fear, dvitiya bhayam bhavati. That's why when most of the religion, what do they say? Oh, Bhagavan will punish you if you don't do that. Or you'll go to narakaloka if you don't do that. Why? Because he's different. In atmajnana, they won't say that if you don't have atmajnana, you'll go to narakaloka. Nay. You will remain here as foolish only. There's no need to go anywhere else. You will suffer here only. You don't need to go anywhere. So, understand here. So, Atmajnanam is aparoksha jnanam. Na karta na bhokta. Vairagya janakaha. Na karma samuchayaha. Whereas, jnanam about the prapancha, about aindrigya jnanam, it is devata icha, devata prapti icha, devata anugraha icha. Then there is a karma, karta, bhokta, everything is there. And there it is, jnana karma samuchaya is possible in upasana. So as I said, samanvaya and samuchaya, these to be understood properly. So Mahavakyas are about making us recognize what we have forgotten, not something which is not. Something which is not there is not indicated. What is already there is made to be seen, reminded us, reminding us. So here, Devata Jnanam is referring to the Indriya Janita Jnanam. It is what is being understood by Indriyas. Though, therefore, if one is doing only karma, that will lead him to karma phalam, which is subject to making you come back and again and again. So therefore, it is tama prapti, or here it is referred as andam tama, darkness they enter. And according to your karma, so will be the birth. If you didn't do the correct thing, then obviously, mudayoni prapti, it will be a lower level of living. Upasana, on the other hand, is indriyarataha. You know, only reveling in the indriyas, the sense organs, and not even doing the karma. Whatever you need to do for the sake of your own sustenance also, if you don't do, that's why in Krishna also says, karmendriyani samya yaste manasasmanan indriyartan vimudhatma mityacharasa ucchate. On the other hand, one who is able to control the sense organs of knowledge and karmendriye karma yogam asaktaha savishishyate. Right? So therefore, in the next verse, samuchaya is pointed out. What? Karma, jnana, samuchaya. Here jnana means indriya jnanam upasana. So avidya, which is of the nature of karma, and vidya of the nature of upasana, samuchaya. Together when you do, that is said here. Anya, before that, he says, these two have different results, which is said in verse number 10. Anya devahur vidyaya, anya dahura vidyaya, idi shushruma dhiranam, yenastat vichachakshire, anya devahura vidyaya, sorry, anya devahur vidyaya, anya dahura vidyaya, idi shushruma dhiranam, enastat vichachakshire. So it is said here, anyat eva ahuhu, those who say ahuhu anyat, anyas means other, ahuhu, who, vidyaya anyat, avidyaya anyat phalam idi ahuhu. Karmanaha phalam pitruloka prapti, upasanaya phalam devaloka prapti. Pitruloka prapti means you go and meet all your ancestors. Somebody asked me this question. So when I don't have a body, my ancestors also don't have a body, how will I recognize them? So pitruloka prapti means it is a field of experiences as a result of your action, not necessarily swarga prapti. So pitruloka prapti is a gestation period before you take a punarjanma. But if you are done the indriya, I mean the devata upasana, then it is swargaloka prapti. And swargam is also what? Bhogaloka only it is. It is also a world, because you have been, so people do so much of upasana. Some people are so inclined to do so much of upasana, but leaving enjoyments here, they think that way, there I go and enjoy more. It is like when you are in a trip to go to, you know, very exotic place, nature's place, you don't enjoy that, you take pictures. Why? Go home and take, look at the dark room, look at and watch. Are, why not you enjoy it here now? So, avidyaya, the result of avidya is what? Karmanaha phalam pitruloka prapti. Upasanaya phalam devaloka prapti or swargaloka prapti. Iti shushruma This is where we have heard dhiranam vachanam, dhiranam vivekinam, viveka purushanam. So those who have already done their contemplation, they have said this very clearly. What? That is what vicha chakshire. Chakshu means to see, actually. Chakshu, you know, see. Chakshu also means vachanam. Both meanings are there. So vicha chakshire means those who are people who have seen and spoken about it. It is not there on their own. They have seen it very clearly and they have revealed to us. So naha tad vicha chakshire, naha for us, tad about the results of karma and upasana, vicha chakshire they have explained to us very clearly. So therefore here, these two independently done, independent results will come. Now the next verse is, if you do together, what is the result? That is given here in the next verse, verse number 11. Vidyam cha vidyam cha yastat vedo bayagam saha avidyaya mrityum tirtva vidyaya mrutam ashnute vidyam cha vidyam cha yastat vedo bayagam saha avidyaya mrityum tirtva vidyaya mrutam ashnute yaha manushyah vidyam cha upasanam avidyam karmanushtanam tad ubayam together saha along with yukabat samuchayena veda. Veda means janadi abhyasati eva. Janadi knows bitter meaning, and veda also means those who have undertaken that. What happens when they do both karma and upasana together? Avidyaya karma anushtanena mrityum tirtva. Mrityum tirtva means pramadam alasyam tirtva. And tirtva means param kritva. Vidyaya upasanaya amrutam devata bhavam sorgaloka praptim anubhavati prapnoti ashnute prapnoti. So here we see veda means anushtana, karma upasana samuchaya. Not merely a karmavadi or manorajyashali. So one is not merely reveling in the thought of it, but he has undertaken the action as well. So karma and upasana put together, when karma is done with the upasana buddhi, then antakarana shuddhi will take place. See, it is said that when rishis were doing karma and not understanding that result is coming from Bhagavan, they become arrogant. Karma is made producing result. Kahan se devata kahan hai isme? This is the nature of all of us when we do action with the kartrutva bhava. Action gives result. Where is the nature of need for God here? That's why in Buddhist philosophy, there is no question of God coming anywhere near that. Karma. So what happens is such a person who does not allow that, karturajnaya prapyate palam karma kimparam karma tad jadam kruti mahautato padanana karanam palam ashashvatam gadi nirodhakam. But when you bring the upasana buddhi, then you understand karma by itself is not giving me result. It is devata anugraha deva. The mind becomes more humble, accepting, gracefully accepting as a prasad. On the other hand, devata upasanam eva karodi yaha, one who does only devata upasana, he becomes dull-witted and he becomes irrelevant to the world. Then. Meaning, you become, most of the time in the name of devata upasana, what they become is karma na karodi. It doesn't do any action. And here devata, as we have seen, the other extrapolated idea is indriya upasana. Such a person become alasi, pramada, mudaha. So therefore it is avidyaya mrityum tirtva, karmana mrityum tirtva, by karma having conquered the death, meaning that karma will take you to the next level of existence because of your karma phala. Karma avidya mrityum tirtva, because tamas is removed, darkness is removed, pramada alasya removed, pramadam vai mrityum aham bravimi, it is said. Pramada alasya is called death. Having crossed that, vidyaya chitta ekagradaya margena devata rupam prapnoti. So one makes chitta shuddhi, which is karma, and devata upasana chitta ekagrada. These two are necessary for jnana prapti. Purity of mind and also clarity. Purity of mind along with concentration. So upasana gives concentration, whereas karma gives chitta shuddhi, antakarana shuddhi, purity as well as one-pointedness. Both when it is gained, is ready for jnana. So therefore, karma upasana samuchaya is a preparation for jnana prapti. Shravana manana nidhyasana will take place only then. So that is why religious relevance of religion in our life is preparation for self-realization. Not directly, but it is preparation. So that's why it is avidyaya mrityum tirtva, mrityu bhayam tirtva, alpatvam tirtva, vidyaya upasanaya ekagrada chintanaya amrutam ashnudai. Here amrutam does not mean immortality of the self, Brahman. Amrutam means devata rupam, devata anugraham, chitta ekagrada dvarena. One-pointedness he gets. That one-pointedness is helpful for the jnana prapti. So that is why it is relevant in this context here. We'll meet at 8:47. Okay.